The notorious Wendigo, the flesh eater from Native American lore, terrorizes lonely wanderers in frozen forests in North America and Canada to satisfy its insatiable hunger for flesh. And of course, it prefers human flesh. This one is one to watch out for, since it's killing everything that it encounters. The question is, what is this creature? A flesh-craving Wendigo survivor story. Gather around, fellow Mythusiasts, for we're about to unveil a chilling cryptid that still intrigues Native American communities and believers, lingering in the shadows of folklore to this day. This terrifying tale has been passed on for generations, but make no mistake, there's more to it than meets the eye. First, let's look at its personal traits. There are two depictions of the Wendigo, the traditional one as a thin zombie, and a more recent one as a deer hybrid. Originating from oral legends from indigenous Algonquin-speaking tribes like Cree, Ojibwe, and the Salto, the term Wendigo roughly translates to evil spirit that devours mankind, and it is typically shown either as a monster with human traits or as a malevolent spirit that possesses a person, transforming them into a horrible creature. However varied its descriptions may be, one consistent belief about this creature is that the Wendigo is a cannibalistic, insatiable, and cruel supernatural being associated with winter, starvation, famine, and death. Despite its sinister description, one might expect the Wendigo to be a massive, hungry predator. Surprisingly, it's not as imposing as one might think. Though said to be almost 15 feet tall, its body is often described as thin and exhausted, which makes sense given its insatiable nature. Constantly obsessed with hunting new victims, the monster remains hungry until it consumes its next victim. The Algonquian legend describes its physical appearance as a giant with a heart of ice, with a skeletal and deformed body, missing its lips and toes. The Ojibwe people described Wendigos as being as tall as a tree with jagged teeth, no lips, and a footprint full of blood. They believe it mercilessly devours any man, woman, or child who ventures into its territory, and that's assuming they were lucky. Also, they attributed paranormal powers to the creature, like it can possess an unlucky person, transforming them into a Wendigo, hunting the friends of who he or she once cared for, and indulging in cannibalistic feasts on their flesh. After hearing all this, we think it's safe to say this isn't the kind of creature you'd want to run into on your weekly hike trip. Further, did you know that Wendigos are also believed to have remarkably keen hearing, eyesight, and sense of smell? And as if that wasn't enough, they're known to be incredibly agile, fast, and strong, enabling them to stealthily stalk and overpower their victims. Living in cold climates among the lakes and icy woodlands, Wendigos seamlessly drift through deep snow and across ice like it's nothing. And guess what? Unlike other fearsome carnivores, the Wendigo doesn't depend on chasing its prey to capture and consume it. They have this mind-blowing ability to mimic human voices and cries. It employs this skill to entice and lure unsuspecting people away from groups. Once the said person is isolated in the remote wilderness, it launches its attack and feasts on them. Super creepy, right? They're so powerful that only a shaman is considered to either subdue or destroy one using a dagger or a bullet made up of, yeah, you guessed it, silver, steel, or iron. Nevertheless, according to certain legends, a Wendigo spirit can only be truly defeated by cutting out its heart and melting or burning it in a fire. In the chilling backdrop of northern winters, where the constant threat of starvation loomed, the Wendigo emerged, its haunting presence marked by an unsettling odor of decay, screams, "Run!" Yet, like all mythical beings, the Wendigo didn't simply materialize into existence. Many experts suggest that it was conceived to discourage people from the horrors of cannibalism, a belief that clashes with ancient traditions. Contrary to popular media portrayals, the Wendigo doesn't spontaneously appear or react violently to colonialism. Rather, it takes shape under specific circumstances, varying across tribal groups. In most tales, the Wendigo is a human transformed into a monstrous entity through a harrowing process triggered by starvation-induced cannibalism and possession by an evil spirit. An alternate version tells the origin of the first Wendigo. During the turn of the 20th century, a warrior who struck a deal with the devil to protect his Algonquian tribe. This all happened in a time of peace. when his warrior skills were not helpful. He was cast out by his unappreciative tribe to live as an outcast, since they felt there was no need for him anymore in the village. After some time, many people from that specific community disappeared. They believed the missing cases were connected to the banned warrior. They thought he transformed into a Wendigo, since they believed the evil spirit could curse humans, possess their bodies, influence their minds, and ultimately transform them into uncontrollable monsters. One of the most infamous cases is the story of a Native American Cree hunter named Swift Runner, who murdered his own family in cold blood and ate them during the winter of 1879. According to reports, Swift Runner believed that he wasn't in control of his body. He asserted that a Wendigo spirit had appeared in his sleep and instructed him to eat his family. Obviously, he wasn't able to prove his innocence and was thus tried for murder, found guilty, and hanged for his crimes later that year. Frighteningly enough, there were quite a few similar cases later on about Wendigo spirits allegedly possessing people in communities stretching from northern Quebec to the Rockies, and guess what? Many of these reports were shockingly identical to the Swift Runner case. In 1907, the Sandy Lake First Nation community in northern Ontario faced a remarkable incident. Tribal shaman Jack Fiddler and his brother Joseph were accused of murdering Joseph's daughter-in-law to prevent her from turning into a Wendigo. After being caught, Jack escaped police custody and took his own life, while Joseph died shortly after from tuberculosis in prison. That is a strange story, right? Then let's see what you think about this phenomenon. In the early 20th century, psychologists and missionaries start using the term Wendigo psychosis to describe a culture-bound syndrome prevalent among Native and First Nations people. It's characterized by a strong desire for human flesh or cannibalism, combined with delusions of being possessed by an evil spirit. Despite its association with historical cases of cannibalism in North America, the syndrome's existence remains a topic of debate among scientists. Another intriguing event that left a lasting mark on Canada's legal landscape occurred in 1897, when the thrilling Wendigo killing trial unfolded. Picture this: an Ojibwe man standing trial for manslaughter, accused of shooting someone he genuinely believed to be a Wendigo. In his cultural context, the act of killing a Wendigo was considered acceptable, but the twist comes when the National Court, in a groundbreaking decision, convicts him. This trial not only delves into the clash between different belief systems, but also sets the stage for a decisive moment where Canadian common law takes superiority over Indigenous ruling traditions. That said, here's the million-dollar question. Does the real Wendigo still roam among us today? With numerous reported sightings spanning from the 1800s to the 1920s, it's a matter we shouldn't take lightly. But every so often, alleged sightings get heated, like recently in 2019, when mysterious screams were echoing through the Canadian wilderness sparked speculation about the possibility of the infamous cryptid being the cause. In fact, one hiker who was present mentioned that while he had heard various animal sounds in the wild before, the noises emanating from this unidentified creature were unlike anything he had ever encountered. That said, whether you believe the Wendigo lurks in the winter forests at night or not, this isn't just another boogeyman story meant to scare people for no reason. It's a very popular story, similar to other creatures' sightings, like the Chupacabra or Bigfoot. Interestingly, there are lakes in the USA named after it, like Lake Wendigo in Minnesota and Wendigo Lake in Wisconsin. Wendigos continues to cast its haunting presence over contemporary pop culture. It has been occasionally portrayed in various popular movies and television series such as Pet Sematary, Supernatural, Grimm, Teen Wolf, Charmed, and the Hannibal series. It was even a major villain in older Wolverine and Hulk Marvel comics and video games. Be that as it may, the consensus is that Wendigos are merely fictional beasts who turned legends in Algonquian folklore to prevent tribe members from partaking in cannibalism. Under the harsh circumstances surrounding winter and a lack of resources, who could blame them for having a fear of starvation? But for those who hold on to the real existence of a Wendigo, there's a belief that it's still out there in the deep forest. And beneath the terrifying, flesh-eating demon lies the story of a simple man who was once just a hungry hunter. That was it for today. Thanks for joining us on this scary exploration of the winter demon. If you enjoyed it, hit the like button to help us bring more legends to life. Until next time, stay curious, stay adventurous, fellow Mythusiasts.